Hello, I'm Jeff Jensen, and I'll be your guide on this video tutorial about making a professional engineering stamp or seal using AutoCAD. I'll show you how to enhance your AutoCAD paper space layouts, templates, and drawings. I'll demonstrate and discuss the application of various AutoCAD commands used to create the AutoCAD block. And in the end, hope to improve your self-confidence, which comes from having the ability to say, I made that. So please join me as I explain the systematic process of making the stamp using AutoCAD. The game plan of this video tutorial is to give you an introduction of why we need an electronic or digital version of a PE stamp. Discuss AutoCAD drawing setup procedures like layers, units, textiles, and so on. Show how to draw the outer circle, rope cord. How to create the inner ring of circles. Using the arctext command to create the circular text. Using the mtext command to create the horizontal text, such as the engineer's name. Convert the completed drawing into an AutoCAD block that can be easily inserted into a paper space layout title block or strip. And hopefully along the way, your knowledge and skills and application of AutoCAD to drafting will improve. Question and answer overview. Question: why do I have to learn how to use AutoCAD and apply this knowledge to creating a professional stamp or seal? Hasn't this already been done by someone else? Yes, and hopefully that someone is you. In learning AutoCAD, we often want to apply our knowledge to something real that is productive and useful. In this video, I'll take you through the steps to recreate a PE stamp. Question: why not just scan a copy of the wet stamp? Yes, this can be done, but the quality of your layout improves when using vectors instead of raster images. There is a noticeable difference in quality between an AutoCAD object and an image of a rubber stamp using an ink blot. Question: hasn't someone already made a digital version of the professional engineer stamps? Yes, I'm sure they have. Maybe you'll be lucky finding one doing a Google search or contacting the state boards, requesting a drawing of their authorized design. But this doesn't teach you how to make it, which is the purpose of this tutorial. Question: aren't wet stamps required on plans? Yes, final plan submittal needed for permit requires a wet stamp, but typically not for plans being reviewed or plan checked. Having a digital stamp will save the engineer time as they won't have to physically stamp each and every sheet, thereby providing a small improvement in the efficiency of the design team. You're watching the executive summary on how to make the PE stamp in 5 minutes. Shown is the completed PE stamp we are going to create. Now I'll window it to select and then delete. I'll set the model space limits to a rectangle size 5 by 2 inches. Then zoom all to zoom to the limit extents. Change the current layer from 0 to General Anno Stamp, which I previously created. Change the point marker symbol from the default of a small dot to a large X. Then create the point using the point command. Change the layer to General Anno No Plot, which was also previously created. Then draw a circle centered at the reference point with a radius of 55/64 of an inch. Draw another circle with the same center and radius of 51/64 of an inch. Then draw a vertical line from the same reference point to the top quadrant of the outer circle. Change the layer to layer 0. Draw a line from the top quadrant with a length of 0.12 inches with an angle of negative 40 degrees. Rotate and copy this diagonal line to negative 5 degrees. Then draw two lines as the top and bottom of the trapezoid. Use the fillet command to change the radius on all four corners of the trapezoid. Finally, use the array polar command to copy the trapezoid around the circle 72 times to give the impression of a rope or cord. Change the layer to General Annotation, No Plot Layer. Draw a circle from the center reference point with a radius of 71/128 of an inch. Change the layer to 0. Create a 72-sided inscribed polygon centered at the reference point. Create a small circle located on the midpoint of one of the sides of the 72-sided polygon. The radius will be calculated by AutoCAD using the tangent object snap and clicking the vertical line. Then use the array polar command to copy the smaller circle 72 times. Change the layer to General Annotation, No Plot. Create a circle centered at the reference point with a radius of 0.63695 inches. Draw a diagonal line from the center reference point at a length of 1 inch with an angle of negative 55 degrees. Create another line at the same reference point, also with a length of 1 inch, and this time with an angle of negative 125 degrees. Trim out the bottom portion of the circle. Change the layer to 0. Use the arc text command to add the curved text along the trim circle. Set the format to alignment center, position convex side, direction to outward from the center, typeface bold, text type professional engineer dash state of Nevada, all uppercase. Text height 0.09, width factor 1.0, character spacing 0.035. Offset from arc 0, offset from left 0. Click OK to accept. Change the layer to General Annotation, No Plot. Use the arc command to create an arc at the same portion which was trimmed out. Change the layer to 0. Type arc text and click the arc. Format alignment center. Position convex side, direction to inward to the center, typeface bold, font Roman D, text type number dot 15737, text height 0.09, width factor 1, character spacing 0.035, offset from arc 0, offset from left 0. Click OK to accept. Change the layer to General Annotation, No Plot. Turn ortho mode on. Create a line from the center reference point up 0.3333 inches. Create another line from the same center reference point a length of 0.22 inches downward. Set the text style to Roman D 9-point scale 1, which was previously created. Change the layer to 0. Use the multi-line text mtext command to hold the engineer's name. Select the text and change the justification to top center. Click outside the text box to accept. Select the text and use the top center grip to move to the top of the 0.3333 inch line. Create another text box. The engineering discipline type civil, all uppercase. Select the text and change the justification to top center. Move the text to the bottom of the 0.22 inch line. Change the text style to Roman D 7-point scale 1, which was also previously created. Type mtext and type exp colon 06/30/17. Change the justification to top center. Move the text to the center reference point. Delete reference guides. And this finishes the PE stamp.